Am I supposed to say something?
No. Because I think I'm just going to, like, I think this is going to be the start of the video.
Okay, we're recording.
What's up, guys? I didn't expect to start today's video this early, as you can see. But I did want to talk to you, before we get into the tech gear that I'm bringing on the trip with me, I did want to talk to you about the three trades that I took this morning. So this was the first trade that I was looking at this morning. I was on the 1 minute here on CAD JPY, looking for divergence off the 800 EMA. The 800 EMA here on the 1 minute chart is the same thing as the 15 minute 50 EMA. So if you look here at the 15 minute, you can see I was trying to buy it off the 50 EMA, taking it higher towards the high a day setback here. It didn't end up working out for me. I ended up taking the loss on the trade for about 5 pips. But because I stayed focused and I was talking to the guys in the VIP chat, I was able to find my second trade. This is GBP CAD. So we were long biased here off the low a day. You can see it set back here at the start of day. We were long biased here as it came back down to retest that level. On the 1 minute chart, Ryan was able to call out some really clean divergence here off the bottom that, as you can see, ended up ripping way higher. I was out of this trade at 171, like 63. It goes all the way up to 172, exactly where I said it was gonna go. As you can see up here, smashes the take profit. I can pull up the P&L too, just to show you guys exactly how my day went. So you can see the first two trades, small positions, 0.25% risk on CAD JPY. Those were the losses. And then the GBP CAD trade I just showed you for about 17 pips. That ended up being a nice size winner because I was a little bit bigger in that trade. And then the third trade of the day, GBP JPY, a small winner, same size as the GCAD trade, but it didn't move as much for me. And I wanted to get out of the trade because I have other stuff that I need to do. I needed to film this video. So here on GBP JPY, I can show you long biased here off the bottom, waiting to see if this thing would rip higher. Now, when it got to the 800 EMA here on the 1 minute chart, I started to see divergence forming on top. The divergence on top was telling me that it could come down, so I ended up closing the trade here in profit. Now, as you can see, it ended up moving a little bit higher. If I had just held on a little bit longer, could have made a little bit more money. But overall, still a really good morning considering everything that we have going on today. So I'm going to get dressed real quick, and then we're going to get into the tech gear. So a lot of you guys have questions about the gear that I take with me on the go to continue trading, to continue running the business. And that's why I want to share with you what I'm packing in my bag for the Dominican Republic for the next 10 days. So the first thing, of course, I can't go anywhere without it, is my MacBook Pro. This is a 2015 Retina display, 15-inch MacBook Pro. It's got an SD card reader, an HDMI port, 2 Thunderbolts, and 2 USBs. It's a really powerful machine for a couple reasons. Number one, when you talk about connecting to your broker and executing orders through your broker, this laptop will never run into any issues. It's got great connectivity. Very, very rarely will I run into a problem. If you want to talk about video editing or photo editing, it's got 16 gigabytes of RAM standard, so it's got a lot of memory, a lot of speed for you. And on top of that, if you're doing 1080 or even 720 editing or basic photo edits, it's going to process very fast. If you get into the 4K stuff, it's going to get a little choppy. So I would recommend maybe getting a faster computer if you need to edit in 4K. But I never do. I don't think most people need to yet. So 1080, it's great. Video editing, it's great. Trade execution, it's great. This computer is the moneymaker. Without this thing, I would not have a business. So this is what comes with me no matter where I go. Now, as we get into the rest of the products that I bring with me, the rest of the gear that comes with me in my bag, guys, if you want to get any of this for yourself, I'm going to have a link below to all of these products. So like here with my charging cable for the MacBook, of course, this comes with me everywhere I go. You see these little black things on the end here? They're rubber. I got them on Amazon and they help prevent the wire from ripping open and fraying. So I really recommend getting those. They're like $3, but that'll save you from having to replace, what is this, $80, $120 for the charger. So definitely get those little black rubber things if you're taking this charger on the go. Next, we have my 2 external hard drives. So that MacBook Pro that I showed you only has 256 gigabytes of internal storage. So not a ton of space when you're doing video edits. So this is my 4 terabyte Seagate hard drive. It's a great hard drive. I always recommend putting them in a case, guys. This is an Amazon, look, Basics case. Like, you can see the tag right there, I think, right? Again, this is linked below. These are cheap cases, but they really do help protect the hard drive. So I always leave it in there, and then I just close the zipper like halfway to leave the cord sticking out, and it's that easy. So I bring this one as my backup. This has some older files on it just in case something was to happen to this one. This is the newer drive. This is 5 terabytes. This is a Western Digital. I just got this, again, linked below. And the case for this one is legit. Like, it's real heavy duty. It's very thick. You can see it's got a couple of layers. Like, the hard drive gets tucked back in here. So this is a legit case for the thing. So these two hard drives come with me everywhere I go. I've got my trading files on there. I've got the video edits on there, all the old media on there in case I need to create a graphic. These have to come with me everywhere I go. So if you're looking for external hard drives, Seagate makes great ones, Western Digital makes great ones, but the thing is, keep them in a case. All right, guys, so the next item is my lavalier microphone by Tascam. I got this off Amazon, again, linked below. This is a really powerful lavalier microphone. This was only $200 and I would highly recommend it if you're creating video content. It comes with all the extras you need. You can plug your micro SD in there, and this is a USB port that'll go right into the computer to transfer the files. The microphone is right here. Comes wrapped up very nicely like this. So very, very simple. I keep extra batteries in the little bag. I keep extra SD cards in the bag. All the extra stuff kind of goes right in here. Nice and protected, nice and zipped up, doesn't get lost. And this gets tucked in the bigger bag. So if you're doing video content, if you're creating content like this, I would highly recommend getting a microphone like the lavalier here by Tascam. So the last thing that I throw in my laptop bag, guys, is this Griffin power bank. It'll charge my phone, it'll charge the Osmo, it'll charge basically anything other than a camera battery. And if you have one of those portable adapters, you can even charge camera batteries with this. So I would highly recommend that if you're on the go, if you're traveling, if you're trading or creating content, you grab a power bank like this Griffin one right here. So when Riley and I travel, we carry two carry-on bags. When you do the carry-ons, you also can bring a backpack. So one of us holds the laptops, one of us holds the camera bag. We're going to get into the camera bag gear in a second, but I want to show you here. I throw my laptop right in here in my protective sleeve. Riley has a laptop sleeve for hers. We tuck that in here. The chargers go in there with the hard drives. She has her own external hard drive. And then the power bank and any other plugs go right in the front here. So this is a really nice backpack. I got this at Joseph Bank. I think it was like $100, a leather bag, but it's protects my stuff. It's small so that you can get on the airplane with it very easily. And it really is awesome to fit both laptops in one bag like this. So this holds our power stuff. This holds the money making stuff. Now I'm going to show you the camera gear. Coming up first out of the camera bag is our brand new, we got it just this year, it was Riley's graduation gift, Canon G7X Mark II. It's a really, really solid point and shoot camera, flip out screen. You can angle it a whole bunch of different ways. You got a microphone on top here. It's got a lot of settings for a point and shoot, and I like that because you can customize, you know, the lighting, you can customize the aperture, you can customize the f-stop. All of that is easy to access here with the touchscreen. So highly recommend the G7X Mark II if you're looking for a point and shoot. This is what we were using for all of our videos up until we got the Osmo, which you're seeing right now and hearing right now. We also have Riley's beautiful camera strap. She's got this linked below for you as well. They had a whole bunch of fun colors like this. It was only $10. Really soft, really solid strap for the camera. Always want to keep this on the camera. That way you can never drop it. You know me and dropping stuff. Now, with the G7X Mark II, of course, you got to bring your Canon standard charger to keep the battery charged. We also grabbed these two extra batteries off Amazon. As you can see, they are off-brand, but they work, and they work really well, so there's no reason why you shouldn't grab them. These are going to be linked below as well. If you have a G7X Mark II or any Canon camera, this company, I don't know how you say that, but this company has batteries for all of it. So again, the link is down below if you need these. Another super important piece to the camera bag is the Joby tripods. We love these tripods. This is my old one. I've had this one for years. Right now, the Osmo is strapped into the black Joby tripod. It's just like this. It's just all black and it's brand new. So it's a little bit stiffer than this one. So this is just our backup, but this gets tucked in the camera bag in the back just in case we need it. Since now we have two cameras, we can put the G7X on this, have one angle here, and the Osmo on this tripod that you can't see, but the Osmo on this tripod to give us that second angle. So highly recommend the Joby tripods. These are very cheap and very durable. Again, this one has been with me for years. Now, for the final piece of what goes into our camera bag, this is the brand new DJI, I don't know why I keep saying DJI Osmo Pocket. So this is the carrying case that we got with it. We bought the expansion kit off Amazon. It was only like $100 more. I think the whole thing cost us $500. Well worth it considering it shoots in 4K, 60 frames per second. Right now you're hearing and seeing it in 1080, 60 frames per second. And as you can see, it's very crisp, very good audio for a small little handheld camera. So it comes with a hard case. Literally, it's this big. Right now I'm filming on it so you guys can't see it, but it's this big. I'm gonna get some B-roll of it and lay that right here so you can see it, but it's very small and it comes with all these accessories. So the wireless module here, which allows you to connect to your phone. It's awesome, very useful. We got the controller wheel stuck in here so you can zoom in, zoom out on the go very quickly. You can see here for our snorkeling coming up next week, I got the underwater casing off Amazon. I think this was $50 separately. Got the charging cable right there. And what we do with this, you can see we have the tripods, all the extenders. Whoops, I'm throwing shit now. All the extenders, all that stuff. And what we do is throw this in the camera bag. All of the gear that I just showed you fits into this camera bag. So let me show you. Finally, guys, this is the camera bag. Again, another Amazon Basics bag. I keep it really simple. No need to spend a lot of money on this stuff. And as you can see, everything fits really nicely in here. I've got the DJI Osmo. Damn it, I did it again. DJI Osmo right here. I've got the Canon G7X Mark II right here in the front, tucked in. It's got these customizable pads in here. You can rip all these apart like this. Look. Like this. And then you can like kind of shift them around if you need to. I like to section it off like that. I got all my accessories for the Osmo right here. I've got the underwater case right here and all those tripods tucked down in here. This one lays here. And then the black one that I was telling you guys about fits right on top. So the Osmo fits, the G7 fits, the strap, the batteries, all of it fits in here. And as you can see, I've got a couple other things up here. I've got some ND filters, a couple extra attachments for the pieces here on the Osmo, but nothing that's super important. We don't really open these too often. All the stuff fits right here in the base. And this works really well because when you close this up, as you can see, it's very small and it fits perfectly as a backpack on an airplane. So Riley carries the camera bag since she's the one doing a lot of the filming, and then I carry the laptop bag. I think it's because the laptop bag is heavier, so she just wants me to carry that one, but that remains to be unknown. So that covers all the gear that I'm bringing with me on the trip this week. Now I need to go pack so we can get out of here and get home to Philly and get on our flight tomorrow morning to Punta Cana. So let's go.
Are you packing?
I'm making progress.
Echo, stop.
I was worried that it wasn't gonna fit, but I'm making progress. And I don't know if those fit, so I gotta try them on. But I got the visor ready to go on top. And all the shirts for all of our pictures. I got every color shirt that we got on the store so we can get some new pictures. And my bathing suits, and I think I should be good. Progress.
We're all packed up, ready to go. What's the plan?
So we're driving back to Philly right now, and then we're sleeping at your brother's house tonight, and then we're waking up early to catch our flight. So I think we can end today's video here. It was pretty good. I hope you guys found it useful. I hope the tech update is beneficial to you. If you have any other tips that maybe I didn't cover that you think other people could find value in as far as what to bring when you travel and you're running a business online or you're trading or you're doing anything with the digital entrepreneur lifestyle kind of thing going on, drop a comment down below. We appreciate it. And we're always looking to network with other people that have some good tips. So yeah, we'll pick up tomorrow's video at the airport.